It's a stethoscope. Stethoscope is a device, a medical aid, which is widely used in the medical industry, right? So the stethoscope nowadays what we are using is currently out of technological one for the moment. So I came up with an idea to improvise the stethoscope with modern technology. So when we are talking about the art sounds, it's lap and tap. So the first sound is occurred when mitral and tricuspid valve closure. And the second sound is occurred when aortic and pulmonary valve closure. Also, there is a factor, S3 and S4, the sound 3 and sound 4, is present during the cardiac cycle, but which is not prominent enough to audible. So we can expect that from a phonocardiogram, something like this. The problems what I came across was the traditional stethoscope is a aid which is widely used, but still it cannot be regulate the sound or the quality of the sound. So I just wanted to improvise the quality or the sound which is audible from that. And also nowadays the telemedicine is getting well developed. The vast widely used medical tool is not supportive to the telemedicine. So if there is a remote analysis and sound analysis part added to the traditional microscope, it can be useful for even telemedicine, kind of. The objective of my project is to make a device which is reasonably priced, because nowadays the market content of the wireless digital stethoscope, which is very expensive, which cannot be afforded by a normal person. So I just wanted to make it an affordable device. Also, my device should be capturing, processing, recording, and outputting a phonocardiogram and an audio signal. I have done a literature survey during my research, and I have mapped everything in this. So I found certain similar reviews and the literatures which I required to do. So I got an idea, and I studied a lot on the literature review, and then I conceptualized my idea. So this is my simplified idea of my device. So the this part is content of the inputs and the processing unit and the output. So the input signal is heartbeat or the body signal. So it can be captured by a sensor. In this case, I'm customizing the sensors by mounting some electric condenser to the chest piece. It's an acoustic sensor. Also, I have a keypad to give certain inputs to the processing unit. In this, I have selected Atmega 2560 unit, which is a suitable Arduino board for my particular device. And also, I get my output as LCD screen. In the screen, I get the BPM, beats per minute. It will be printed on the screen. Also, the speaker will be showing out the heartbeats and all that. It is not limited to a person. We all can hear via speaker. The headphones also possible. MATLAB visualization, that is a phonocardiogram real-time review. And GSM module is attached in the system in order to get a SMS to the practitioner. Anywhere else, we can just measure the amount and send them. And the ST memory card chip also interferes with the system. So it is used to save the data, and for the future analysis, we can use that. These are the components I have selected during my research on a device. Each component has certain requirements, so these met my requirements and I have selected them accordingly. So the data presentation and the hardware implementation was done in two types. One, I have completed the hardware design, and then I came up with the software implementation. For the hardware implementation, I first of all made a sensor which is user-friendly. There is no harm with the patient or the person who is operating with that. And then I come up with an amplifier circuit, and then further the processing unit, and then the outputting components. Further, the software algorithms were made up accordingly. There was five keys. So the first key is about playing the recorded sound, and the second key is about record the sound, and third key is about measure the BPM. That will be measure for 60 seconds. It will get the spikes, and then key 4 is to send SMS. So in that mode, it will ask a number, and once we included the number, it will send the measured BPM brain to a person. And fifth key is to MATLAB view. So MATLAB view is plotting a phonocardiogram in a real time view. So this is my device. I have used a transformer to power up the device by using the main current. Also the circuit is shown in the second picture. And the third picture is the sensor I used in the I used for acoustic sensor. And these are the LCD screen views, digital stethoscope and all that. This is my results. This will be a phonocardiogram from a MATLAB preview. So real-time view is gained from the MATLAB. And the SMS body is shown. So this is how it measures the BPM rate and sent to a person. The conclusions are, I'm using a step-down transformer to power up the device, and modified sensor unit is capable of capturing the heart signals without any harm, and the amplifier circuit is built up in order to qualify the data, and there is a recording and storing process is facilitated. Also, the real-time review is became possible with MATLAB software. So the future works, there were certain things I couldn't come up with. So during the project, I faced lot of error, noisy kind of signals. So if I come up with correct filters, so I can improvise the noise, so it will make sense more. Also, the heart murmurs and heart flows and all that, if I can something found out with that, if I can make the data is quite sensible, more than that, then I can come up with the idea to find out the murmurs and some heart flows and tunnels, things like that. So it would add more value, I guess. Thank you.
Thank you.
One thing I was worried was that noise. Also, I was just thinking about one example, breathing.
Okay.
You think you can, does that add to the noise? For an example, if someone is not actively breathing at the time.
Yeah, I can differentiate the lung sound and the cardiac sound.
Okay.
But still, I need to find out some more algorithms to make it more sensible.
So when you are talking about filtering, is it about digital filtering? And you are happy with, you think that, I don't know exactly what the acoustic sensor is, but perhaps the quality of the sensor also might matter because you are depending on that to get your input.
My objective was to make a priced, reasonable
objective. So you try to invest heavily onto the more the filtering part, which can be done relatively cheaply.
Yes.
But in terms of the, let's say, the quality of your recording, let's say you record that noise, the output that is coming from your device, and perhaps another thing that you could add to that is see if the voice is reproduced, maybe you can get the help of a physician, and if he can listen to that sound, then maybe he can check with the correlate that with the patient sound that he can get and see, you know, to get a human input as well.
Yeah.
Just a suggestion that you can do.
I think this is bloody brilliant. what do you think the cost is going to be like?
For me, it was around 20. I mean, I spent 20,000 because.
I think that's the cost of a late one.
No, no. When I was trying this, but when it is outputted, it won't be that cost.
Because I think the late one costs that much. What I would suggest is the SMS sending the BPM.
Yeah.
If you could devise an algorithm to see if it's regular or irregular, that would be useful to a physician as well.
No, in my mode, if I want only, I can send the SMS. There is a specific mode.
Yeah.
So earlier I was come up with the idea that when the modes are irregular, automatically the value will be sent to a person already the program. But in this model, if there is an option, so in the fifth option I have given that the SMS for, if we add the number, it will automatically send the SMS.
Yeah, so if you can, if it just says if it's regular or irregular as well, you can get a device and algorithm for that as well.
Yeah.
It will be very useful.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.